by the French development agent was laid by His Excellency the President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, Dr. Emmerson Nambuzi Mnangagwa, on 30 June 2022.
Yeah. It is an honor and privilege to address you all as we witness the signing of a partnership agreement between the French Development Agency and the National Museums and Monuments of Zimbabwe in a project to conserve the great Zimbabwe monuments where we are. This development is most opportune and is in sync with my government's desire to ensure the recovery, growth, and ultimately increase the contribution of the tourism sector to the overall growth of our country's economy. On behalf of the people and government of Zimbabwe, and indeed on my own behalf, I want to express my profound gratitude to the French government for the generous gesture extended to us in heritage management and conservation. Ndirikuda kutenda President of France, Baron Macron, vari kuda kusumudzira ukama pakati peZimbabwe neFrance. Saka pakauya Second Republic, vakatuma delegation yavo kuno ikasangana neni 3 years ago. Tikataurirana, tikavapa zvakawanda kuti vaite, vakasarudza kuti tiri kuona kuti nyaya yehistori yenyu yeZimbabwe haisi kusimudzirwa, toda kutanga naikoko. Saka nhasi tiri pano. Saka ndoda kuatenda. The partnership between the French Development Agency and the government of Zimbabwe in the preservation and promotion of the Great Zimbabwe Monument is indeed a welcome initiative. It speaks volumes about the excellent relations that exist between our two great peoples and governments. Dangachitaura patata kapfigira nao kuti mazitete guredu akavaka panapa ndopanga pane capital city yenyika ino vachitonga ivo vakavaka headquarters ino iyi zvatiri kuona zvavakasiya izvi ndanchiudza vamwe vangu kuti tava nemakore makumi mana nemakore maviri tasungunuka asi igore rino under the Second Republic patafunga kuti inga tinobvepiko saka tatanga rwendo rwekutizivisane nokukudza madzitateguru edu tichichengedza vakavaka. This project is a culmination of a visit by the French delegation in November 2018, whereupon, after meeting them, a wide range of cooperation initiatives including investment in the cultural heritage sector, was agreed on. I commend all stakeholders for making a decision to focus the partnership to target the Great Zimbabwe World Heritage Site here in Masvingo Province. Waunza mari, 3 million euro. The interventions of this project will go a long way in enhancing the realization of our country's tourism recovery and the growth targets. The multidimensional package of interventions of this project, which include documentation ino rera kuti tinofanira kuwana vana zvina mfundo vanoziva panapa tina vamahasha vambotaura vaya nokuti tikabvunzana mamakagaramo nevakagara kuno kuti pano pakamira sei unowana stori dzakawandisa saka toda kuti vana funda zvina fundo sana mahasha vativudze vonyora pasi kuti zvakamira zvakati zvakamira zvakati zvakatanga gore ripi zvikaita sei kuitira kuti tichengetedze history yedu. That is about documentation about this site. Then there is the question of conservation. Kuchengetedza pano kuchengetedza zvinoonekwa namaziso semudhuri yatinoona iyi kuchengetedza zvakare chivanhu chedu chatoti spiritual culture yedu ichengetedzwa pano. It is our duty as the current generation to preserve both the tangible and intangible heritage of the site. Installation of interpretation visitors facilities at the site, as well as commercial management and marketing of the site, are a welcome development. In line with the United Nations World Tourism Organization spirit of tourism for all by 2030, I urge the tourism, travel and hospitality sector players, and in particular the National Museums and Monuments of Zimbabwe, to take heed on the barriers that encumber visits to our tourist attraction sites. Ride on the use of technologies as the best ways to brand and market our tourism products in both traditional and emerging markets. The capacity building of the national museums and monuments, as well as strengthening of research and development under this project, must propel the tourism development and marketing vision of this iconic monument. Over and above this, the envisioned interventions to improve community livelihoods based on innovative and territorial level management solutions dovetail with the country's community-based tourism enterprise strategy. In this regard, the funding for the development of tourism incubation programs must continue to ensure that our local communities participate in the sector's value chains. This will ensure that our people enjoy the benefits of our rich heritage and natural endowments. The modernization of the Nemamwa Craft Center and the cultural hub, as well as the training in environmental management practices, amongst a myriad of other outcomes of this project, must be speedily implemented. Comrades and friends, the Great Zimbabwe Monument is one of our country's national tourist attractions owing to its significance at both the national and global level. Our independent and sovereign country, Zimbabwe, derives its name from this sacred national monument and heritage site. It is the physical embodiment and expression of our national identity. Munomu Zimbabwe. Ewongu tinendimi dzakasiyana asi Zimbabwe is one. Azvinei kuti unotaura rudzi rupi kana rurimi rupi, you remain Zimbabwean. Uye bumbiro mutemo wedu, our constitution recognizes 16 official languages, and all those languages are officially spoken in Zimbabwe. Saka nokuwira nokubatana tinokwanisa kuvaka tigovaka tichingovaka asi chingowirana ukatara chirudzi chako techingohwanana tese. This place remains our source of pride, inspiration, a cradle of our civilization, rich heritage and culture bequeathed to us by our forefathers. It is no coincidence, therefore, that this monument was designated a national monument as well as World Heritage Site. This epitaph of our nationhood possesses an outstanding universal value that transcends national boundaries and is indeed an embodiment of the rich African civilization. To us in Zimbabwe, the monument is not only about its grandiose architecture, but a revered national shrine and a place of worship that symbolizes our sacred cultural traditions and belief systems. I therefore take the opportunity of this occasion to applaud our government, our stakeholders, traditional leaders, Mazimambedu, and our communities here in Masvingo Province for preserving, protecting, and safeguarding this world heritage. That singleness of purpose in safeguarding this revered shrine for the benefit of our country, Zimbabwe, and for mankind in general must remain a priority. A people without knowledge of their history, origin, and culture is like a tree without roots. Hence, we are obligated to preserve our country's diverse and rich cultural heritage. We must be alive to the fact that our protracted armed struggle for independence also revolved around the importance of Great Zimbabwe Monument, as the oppressive white minority regime had the intention of denying us, the Zimbabwean people, of its ownership and authorship. The failed ploy to underplay our forefathers' human creativity was realized through a protracted war of liberation. Today, we are an independent, free, democratic, and sovereign country. Never again, never again will our country and our people be subdued in any form. We will continue to leverage on our rich heritage, best development alternatives to grow, modernize, and industrialize our great motherland, Zimbabwe. Mu 2020, muna December, takaenda ku Dubai. ndakada kuti Dubai kunoadresa forum yemabusinessmen ndobva ndavataurira zvakanaka pakuti Zimbabwe anga achingova chena voga zvakanaka vanambofara pane umwe chete ochiindia akasimuka akati akabvunza mbvunzo mbibi akadza pezvamataura izvi tafara nazvo ndoda kuuyako saka akazovuya ndiye takavhura factory nezuro kumausekwa ndo engagement ari engagement yanga ichitaurwa panapa iyi vavuya vava engagement reengagement taita nyaya navo kuti vuyai kuno vakavona kuti vanhu kwavo saka vavuya vacharamba vachingovuya This iconic monument bears a unique and undeniable testimony of the production economic and governance system embedded in our culture and civilization The unifying force that builds this great country emboldens us to work harder towards the realization of our national vision 2030. To this end, we will unapologetically invest in our local economy, construct our roads, construct our dams, construct our schools, construct our clinics, our hospitals, produce what we eat, manufacture what we put on, the clothes, and safeguard our peace, unity, and cultural heritage. Ladies and gentlemen, to date, different groups have been converging at this cultural heritage site for religious and spiritual functions. Hence, the need to positively enhance the overarching originality and heritage integrity of this site. Hama Zangu, I once again commend the French government and President Macron. Through the French Development Agency for cooperating with us in the area of heritage management and conservation. This cooperation must continue to weave the intricate link between culture and sustainable socio-economic development. This is more critical as climate change. Munongoiona kuti tiri muna July asi mvura yamazuva kuno kunanzwa na zvadzamira kwaizva ndereta kuti ichingonaya yongo asi ichisvasvanga nechando asi ichinaya zvayo saka this change of climate ndiye anonzi climate change Also, the COVID-19, illegal sanctions, and emerging global shocks. Now, all these things are challenges. Climate change is a challenge, so we must find methods of mitigating against climate change. COVID-19 is a challenge, so we also must find ways of mitigating the impact of COVID-19. Illegal sanctions are a challenge. So again, we must find ways of mitigating against the impact of illegal sanctions. Now, currently, we have global shocks. Wondo yama Russia nema Ukraine kusoroku. Kwabari kusashangana ikoko. It's not affect our kuno. As we must make sure kuti on the basis of our domestic resources we must survive we must build our own country because nyika So these shocks and challenges entail the increased need to build adaptive and resilient capacities domestically. In conclusion, my government remains committed to the successful implementation of this project. We stand ready to welcome French tourists, Your Excellency Ambassador, and investors across all sectors of the economy. With these remarks, it is now my honor and privilege to declare the French Development Agency and the National Museum and Monuments of Zimbabwe's partnership project officially launched. I wish you all great success as you implement this project. God bless you all. God bless Zimbabwe. I thank you.